In this video, I'm going to show you the four-step process to MIDI map any controller in Ableton, as well as the three different types of MIDI mappings that are available to you. And for those of you who stick around to the end, I'm going to show you my three power mappings that you need to be using to operate Ableton efficiently without touching your mouse. Brett Pontecorvo here at livekeyboardist.com, where I help keyboard players just like you with the ins and outs of Ableton, with sound design, and with live performance techniques. Now, if you're new here, please consider hitting that subscribe button. Please consider liking this video. But without any further ado, let's jump in. So in order to MIDI map in Ableton, you're going to need a couple of things. The first thing you're going to need is a controller. So today I'm using the Keylab 88, but any controller will do, even if you're using like a Novation Launch Control XL or whatever controller you have will definitely work. You're also going to need a copy of Ableton, a USB or a MIDI cable, and a way to connect that to your computer, either directly or with a USB hub. All right, so now that we've got the hardware out of the way, let's check out the four-step process for MIDI mapping in Ableton. The first step is to open up your settings. So we can do that in two ways. We can either go here and click Live, Preferences, or if we want to be super fast, we can hit Command, comma. Now, under the Link MIDI tab, down here at the bottom, you're going to see this MIDI ports option. And we have inputs and outputs. And this tells Ableton how we are going to handle incoming information. So you're going to want to find your controller, and mine is the Keylab 88. And you're going to want to make sure that remote is turned on. Now, if you're using a keyboard, you probably also want track turned on. And I have a full video explaining the ins and outs of this. Now, if you're using a controller that has light feedback, something like a launch control or a launch pad rather, you're going to want to make sure that the output is turned on for remote as well, because that's how those lights end up working. Okay, cool. So our preferences are now completely out of the way. So now we have to enter MIDI mapping mode. And there's also two ways to do that. We can either click MIDI or we can have Command M. And that'll bring us into MIDI mode. And you'll notice now that on the screen, there are highlighted parameters. Anything that is highlighted is mappable. And the process to map it is really easy. Just click on what you want to map and move what you want to map it to. But as I mentioned earlier, there are actually three types of MIDI mapping. So let's explore those a little bit. The first is what I like to call a continuous mapping or a fader mapping. So with something like volume, if you're mapping a knob or a fader, this is a sort of continuous setting. Now, when I exit MIDI mapping mode, whatever I mapped, I'm going to have control over. But what's cool is you can actually change how much control you have. So for example, with volume, you probably don't want to be going above zero, and maybe you want to be able to drop the level down, but you don't want it to totally drop out. So I've set my values there. And now you'll notice I have a certain amount of control, but not outside of the parameters that I have set for myself. Now the second type of mapping is a toggle. This is like an on-off switch. So I'm going to go ahead and map a toggle button to the speaker here. And now you'll notice when I hit it once, it's on, and when I hit it again, it's off. So that's our toggle mapping. And the last one is a gate mapping. Now a gate mapping has a control active when you're pressing the button, but when you lift your hand, it no longer is active. So I'm going to map that to solo here. So now when I hold it down, I've got solo, and when I lift it, solo goes off. And this can be handy if you want to just have something kind of momentary that's happening. But congratulations, you've made it to the end of the video where I'm going to show you my three power mappings that you need to be using to control Ableton efficiently without a mouse. The first power mapping is being able to move throughout session view without your mouse. So to do that, we're going to enter MIDI mapping mode, and we're going to map a continuous controller to one of these guys over here, right next to the down arrow. And what that's going to do is allow me to vertically scroll without ever using my mouse, so I can really quickly jump around the set. Now, my second power mapping allows me to turn sounds on and off. So if I enter MIDI mapping mode and I map a button to my chain selector, I'm going to be able to toggle a sound on and off. So minimum is zero. I'm going to set my maximum to one. And now when I hit this button, you're going to notice that I'm able to have it so that when I hit it once, I've got this muted. When I hit it once, I've got sound, and when I hit it again, no sound at all, which is a really nice feature. And my third one, which is the simplest but perhaps the most profound, is your volume faders. Now, this might seem obvious, but this is something you're going to be touching all the time. So if it's a common thing, we want to really make sure that that is mapped. Now, if you're ready to go a little bit deeper, what you can do is go ahead and click on this video here that's going to show you the real ins and outs of the MIDI settings in Ableton. And if you're trying to map your controller to the tempo of Ableton, it's a little bit different than what I shared today. So this video here is going to help you to do that. Now, please make sure you click that like and subscribe button and check out one of these videos, and I will see you next time.